G'day, how you doing? I've had quite a few people ask me how I make my Berley, so yeah, I just thought I'd make a little short video of what I do and this is how I go about it. So it's pretty simple. You can't beat homemade Berley, it's a lot cheaper, and you get all these common things around the home, and yeah, it saves you on the pocket and you're guaranteed to get a lot more fish. This is what I've got. So what I do is I blend all mine in a blender. I don't use a mincer or a grinder, probably just because I don't have one. So I just use a small blender. If you've got a bigger blender, it's better. Maybe even a food processor is even better, but I'm not going to take the food processor out of the house. So what I've got here, I've got some old fish frames, some old fish frames from fishing yesterday. So I've got like flathead in there. That's about it really, actually. Flathead frames. I've got some old bait like pilchards, cockles and some squid. All the manky stuff that's no good for catching anything. Got some old bread. Yeah, just find some old bread. Everyone's got bread. It's been in the freezer for a long time. Chook pellets. These are just your normal chook pellets. I don't know what they are. Like, I think it's about $20 for 40 kilos of this stuff. And because I have chooks. You need some water for the blender. It helps the blender move to process it a lot easier. I've done it before without water in there and I've blown the blender. So you're better off making it a little bit easier, add a little bit of lubrication. Everybody likes lube. Paper towel, because the stuff does go everywhere. In saying that, make sure you do it inside the shed or outside. Don't do it in the house because at the moment it doesn't smell, but as though like all fishing and bait and stuff, you're guaranteed it's going to go everywhere where you don't want it. And you think you cleaned it up, but you haven't. And it gets smelly. So even in your shed, just do it on top of some cardboard. It's a knife, just cut things a little bit smaller, make it a little bit easier for the blender. And I've got some old cat food, just home brand stuff, which I like to throw in there. It's just a pilchard based. It's yeah, I usually use this stuff when I go shark fishing. It's brilliant, but I haven't been shark fishing for a while, so I thought I'd use it. And that's basically it. And what I do is I'll put it through the processors and I'll show you how to do it. Oh, for storing purposes, after I've blended it all, what I do is I just put it in like an old 1 liter milk carton, cut the top off, and fill it up, and put the tape around there, and put it in the chest freezer. And in saying that, don't put it in the freezer in the house because your mum or your missus won't be too keen. Make sure it's the one in the shed. Righto, so what I'll start with is the old fish frames. So as I said, you know, you don't want to do this inside because this stuff's pretty filthy to go play with. You want to make sure you're wearing not your good clothes too. Throw a bit of water in. Just helps the blender mash it up a bit. Put a lid on. As you can see, it's relatively pureed. There's a few lumps and bumps in there, so I'll just throw the blender on a little bit longer. Yeah, that's not bad. Check that out. Smudge. What I'll do is drop some more in there. So I've got some old garfish frames. Now, garfish, they're also great bait. You can keep the heads, but I've already got a whole heap, which I'm going to put away, and these are just the frames I thought I'll cook up. I didn't get any big guards the other day, but I thought I still want to eat them anyway. Alrighty, check that out. That's a really good fine mixture there. It's not totally pureed, but it's nice and lumpy, so when that's in the what are you going to call it, your burley bucket or bag, after you freeze it, there's a nice big lump. That'll just slowly break down over a period of time, and it's just perfect. That's the consistency you want. You don't want it too fine, because it'll just disperse way too easy once it de-thaws. You want the bigger stuff, so it's going to get caught in the burley bag or bucket, so it's going to last a little bit longer. And if you're going for things like gar, you don't particularly want to be feeding on all the small stuff. Alright, what I might do is Yeah, I think they might. Oh, drop a couple more gar in. So other things to get. So you basically just mix it up, really. Like old pilchers, for example, they're no good. Drop a few of them in. What's really good about them, they're really rich in oil and attractants and so forth. A few of those in there. Old squid head, cockle, pippy, depending where you're from. That sounds alright. So what I like to do is get a bit of bread. It doesn't matter what type of bread you use, it's all the same either way. But I like to get, say, a big bit of bread. And get a container. And just break it up in there. And then just get this and pour it in. As you can see, it'll be nice and thick. Looks kind of gross actually, doesn't it? Last time we used salmon frames. Didn't look so bad as this. Alright, and then what I like to do is just get a few chook pellets. Sprinkle them on top. Just get your knife and stir them through. Just wrap some tape around it, make sure you get it concealed, just wipe that stuff off the side. You can get tape pretty cheap, like $2 for a roll of this. I want to skimp and get you cellophane or cellophane tape, what do they call it, the clear stuff. Because that'll just unstick since it freezes. Just for the purpose of transporting and so forth, you don't want to go through tape just in case it needs or whatever, you don't want to go through your stuff. There you go, 1 litre of Berley. Yeah. And also, yeah, as I said, put it outside, not only because it's got to smell a bit, you don't want someone else drinking it. Not that they would. So yeah, that's how I make Berley. Hope you learned something from that. As I said, it's cheap, and yeah, it just makes your fishing so much better. You're guaranteed to get a lot more fish by just making your own Berley. You get the Berley bombs, like they cost like $10 or whatever they are. This stuff here costs me nothing. It's all stuff laying around the house. Chicken feed, like not everyone's got chooks, but you don't really need that. Bread's enough as it is. But yeah, that's how you do it. And, you're guaranteed to get a lot better quality fish. Is a frame which I got down here, Port Phillip Bay, of a flathead. It's not a bad size flathead, like it's one of the bigger models you get down here. But yeah, up compared to Queensland and so forth, this is nothing. This is just a pup. But down here, that's something you really want to take home. And I'll thank you for watching.